Hi, I'm Warrior.
And I'm Jetbat.
And I'm Mumra, and here we are on a bomb mission. Oh, look at that! 1866. Oh.
We saw Tifa in an early episode of Route 15. I mentioned the name. It happened. You guys feel free to, you know, go back and check. I think it was actually in the same map. I'm pretty sure it was in MM. Don't quote me on that. Don't quote me. But level 6 already? Jeez. Wait, what? Is this our 6th video? 6 videos in level 6? No, can't be that simple. It can't be that simple. It's what? I hate it when they do that. I've seen someone join mid-game before. It happens.
Well, I actually don't blame that guy. I blame Konami, because that's happened to, you know, that's happened to everyone. You know, you got a black screen for ages, and you're like, what do I do?
Yeah, that happened to me ages ago, and I started freaking out, and we actually started talking on mic.
Yeah,
I've had that as well.
You say on the mic. No, some people see it as a new loading screen. It resets to 60, and people just look at the loading screen. But most people get a black screen.
Yeah, you just wait it out, be patient, and then you're all just a pair. And hopefully the other team, if they're not on mic, they just, you know, they just fuck off and think, oh.
Free win.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. But now, one topic that I thought we'd... This is actually a pretty sizable episode that I think we could devote a good chunk of the episode to for topics was MGO2.com and how really, I think it is really the core community of all of MGO. What are your guys' opinions on it?
I wouldn't call it the core. I think the core would actually be the people who still play survival, but MGO2 community, it's there. It's there.
Well, I only have 50 posts. I have under 50 posts since its conception, and I was one of the first people as well to sign up as well to it. But you know, and I've got I've not had much conversation with them, but I've got people like Sin, the owner of the site. And, you know, DS and a couple of other, like, top people from the MGO2 site on AIM.
I believe that actually Staircase is the owner of MGO2.com, not Sin.
Oh, really? Not Sin? Oh, okay.
I could be wrong.
Oh, yeah, Staircase. No, you could be right. Well, I've got them both on.
Mm-hmm. Me personally, I think the site's cool. I think it's pretty ambitious when it comes to a game like MGO and its community. I think it looks nice. I think it's very well designed. And I thought it looked very professional. When I first stumbled upon it, I thought, wow, this actually looks really rather nice. But then when I saw the community, my hopes kind of faded to be
You say that, but yes. Yeah, that's pretty sweet, actually.
Mm-hmm. I love when that happens.
Take that guy out as well, though.
Yeah.
I prefer the MGO2 forum than the TGF. Just personally, though. Not an attack on my fellow Europeans, but I think there's less bullying and just less. I think it's more welcoming.
The
MGO2. Really?
Yeah. Again. So again, once again, I'm saying, you know, NA server seems to be more welcoming. And,
double tap there. Just saying.
Oh yes, double tap. Always
I'm appalled that you are saying these things. This is
same here. I really thought I would learn the definition of asshole in spending time.
I think you just haven't had enough gameplay in NA. That's what I think.
Well, then I was about to suggest that as well. Actually, that perhaps you know, when people start, now that people know who my character is and stuff, that, you know, when I start winning where I shouldn't with teams that I shouldn't be winning with, then people might, you know,
but
start
you
to catch
there.
On my view.
Maybe it wasn't. Maybe the guy was just hugging the wall. I don't know. Looked like a teabag. Did. Yeah. I saw it. I saw his name go up and down.
Well, it's an interesting thing that I always thought was pretty weird was that, well, with MGO, you have the CSP, the community support page, and that's where I hooked up. Yeah.
I'll tell you an interesting fact. In MGO, were any of you guys privy to MGO 1?
No, I wasn't.
MGO 1 had a real, forum.
Okay.
Created for it. Run by, like, real, like, employee, like, live employees of Konami. Because the CSP is just there, it just exists. No one's looking after it. There's no admins or mods or anything like that. Whereas the MGO 1 had, you know, had these things. So it's a bit like, you know, TGRF or TGF or MGO2, but with like real people, like banning people, moderating and all that, which was really something good. You know, basically, it was, in retrospect, it looks like Konami cared, you know, because they had someone on the books looking into things, you know.
At the same time, I think it's good to have both, because on the CSP, everyone's the same. There's no subdivisions, like moderator, but you do want moderators. So
oh, yeah,
that's good to have both, I think. Mm. Oh, by the way, smoke grenades on bomb, very, very important.
I think the one most interesting thing about the whole MGO2.com and then the CSP is that they're just two, like, isolated communities. When I was on the CSP with our original clan, I had no clue MGO2.com existed. I thought the CSP, that was the core of the majority of the community. And I thought that by going there, I would get myself known. I would get to play with known players, but really, there's just two different breeds.
Oh, Reefer 3. What is it? 3 for 1 Thursday. That is the term. That is the term for that.
Very proud of that. And look what they did for my troubles, for as acknowledgement of my ownage.
He gets some hot, sweaty action.
That was my first teabag on the NA servers.
Oh man.
Do either of you know, why is it that Japanese players take offense to salute? It is their form of teabag.
Really?
If you kill someone and then salute, it is apparently the equivalent to teabag. Unless it's at the end of the round, in which case
Where
it isn't.
Where did you get this information from?
I have Japan MGO, and people tell me Mega Daddy was one, and the people who usually play on there said that you don't want to salute.
Wow.
So instead, you want a teabag.
Yeah, that's a good point.
That's quite interesting. I mean, the game is made by Konami, and they put saluting in the game, so it's like... If they wanted the nephew, they could have made the character to a middle finger.
Yeah. Juno got the fever.
Juno's actually a rather nice fellow. He's been in the clan for quite some time.
I love Juno. I don't have his PSN.
To what you were saying about community jetpack, is like, I find that really interesting that you're talking about getting to be known or whatever. Or me personally, I'm not a very, you know, obviously I run and co-founded with Desert Viper, hewhodares.com, and you know, basically that's where I exist, that's where I'm at. I have like very little to no contact with any MGO community.
Yeah. Alright.
So it's really interesting hearing you talk about community, or you know, it being contained or not contained or good or bad, because you know, the only community that I've ever been exposed to for these 2 years has just been that of my own players, in our own goldfish, effectively. Mm-hmm. And for the most part, I can only speak for myself, because that's the way I personally like it. I do have members that are on like MGO2 and TGF, but you know, for the most part.
Yeah.
That's a very good point. That's very interesting. And you know, I can relate to that, because I remember when I was on the CSP, I only made contact really with my clanmates, and even we mentioned it in a prior video in this series where we had a rivalry with this other clan.
That was off camera.
We had a rivalry with this other clan when we were in our original clan. I didn't even interact with them, and they were on the CSP. I really only talked with people within our original clan, so I was isolated from all other communities in MGO for that reason. So while people in our clan would know, oh, I know these guys, I've seen them before when we play them in survival, or these guys are douchebags, I would have no clue.
Well, that's the thing. I don't know whether it's a good or a bad thing, such isolation. But for me, I know that it's a healthy thing, because, you know, I'm a curmudgeonly old man. I don't really, I just like sticking to, oh, I hate that.
That sucks.
Oh, and he had the bomb as well. God damn it. That's another thing I've been finding as well. I've been finding CQCs hard to time. I don't know why, but CQCs seem to fail for me.
I give up on it.
Another thing as well I hate as well is the fact that I will have more pings, like greater ping, than you guys, than some of the natives.
Yeah.
What the
Mexican.
You know, seriously.
Mech Revolutions. If I see them in a game, I'm like, okay, can we rage quit now?
Can we please insult them?
Just the other day.
Can we please begin the flaming?
You say that, but do you remember that res match where we tore them?
Oh yeah.
It's like that's another thing as well. I don't. That's what's good for me is that I don't have any of the preconceptions that you guys have, because obviously you know the reputations that precede other clans. So for me, every clan I treat equally, and you know. That doesn't hinder my performance.
Yeah. And to be fair, it's not like we're just hating on the clan. They gave themselves that reputation and they stick with it. It's not like we're just mildly hating on them.
Basically, as I think you've said it before, it's like it's your equivalent of KSA.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, I haven't heard of them.
Mm. Yeah, that's the KSA stand for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, who don't give... we have, you know... There are some KSA members that have no problem with the connection, but that's like, you know, the 10% maybe, if that. And the other 90 to 99% are just the laggiest players you'll ever come across. You know,
I can imagine. Well, you know, I got to level with you guys quickly. My video's off, so please carry me.
Okay.
Oh, we'll have to carry you. Right. No, it's almost the end anyway. So.
Yeah, but still, it's just they. It's not like I just hate them on them because they're. Yeah. Well, I hate them on them because they're douchebags sometimes. But they're just they give themselves the reputation and they don't try to fix it. They're fine with it. That's my gripe with them. But whatever.
I think it's really interesting when you talk about reputations as well because it's I have a very I've always. Had our clanmates under in the frame of mind that you know, look, you join here, you know, it's our mandate not to give a fuck, you know, because you can't really you in this world you can't control what people think about you in any facet, gaming, life, whatever. It's a full time job, and even you know, even politicians and dictators can't do it. You know, look in your history books.
Yeah.
You know, like so, in my opinion, just be what you're going to be, who you are going to be, and just your actions should dictate. What your reputation is to other people.
Yep.
And you know, and if it's not what you think, you know, and if it's not to your liking or whatever, then that's just you know tough. What can you do?
Yeah.
Sign off time.
Quick sign off. ParallaxyHooters.com Productions. Yes.
Peace.
Later.
Please rate this video what you think it deserves. Sign up at HeWhoDares.com. Thanks for watching.